London 2012. And in the blue, representing France, and Caroline Graffe. In the red from Serbia, Milica Mandic. The number one seed versus the number seven seed. 26 years of age versus 20 years of age. This bout has it all. There's how Mandic has made it here. Strong winner, comprehensive winner in the semi-finals against Russia. She defeated the Olympic champ Espinosa of Mexico in the quarterfinals as well. That was a big scalp. And Graf, her semi-final against Hernandez, 6-4, the victory. Cuban went on to crank that form, taking bronze. And here's the referee from the Netherlands. So they are the formalities. Now comes the battle for gold. The loser takes silver. The winner gets the big prize. Yes, and Caroline Graffe, some of the word from her coach, herself has been on this stage. Frenchwoman, Myriam Pavelel, silver medal in Athens. So well coached is Graffe. And on the side of Mandic is a thing called youth, just 20 years of age. What a wonderful thing it is for her to be here on this gold medal stage, the games of the 30th Olympics. And with that, we are underway in the women's heavyweight gold medal bout. France in blue, Serbia in red. Graffe and Mandic. And the fist to the trunk, almost. Graffe now looking to attack. The lead leg repelled by Mandic. The swinging right, unable to score. I'm not afraid of anyone here. I want to be Olympic champion, says Anne-Caroline Graffe. Well, it's all before her now. Climbing into the air to try to score. Then with the fist, not once but twice to the trunk, and one got through. One of the two blows made contact with the trunk protector. And the automated scoring system responds. And now Mandic on the board as well as she makes contact to the body. 1 point for a punch or a kick to the trunk. A spinning or turning kick to the trunk is 2 points. A kick to the head, 3 points, and the maximum 4 points for a turning or spinning kick to the head. Spectacular when you see these ladies attempt that, and we definitely will at some stage. Wary of what each other's bringing to the table in this gold medal game at this stage. The swinging left to the trunk, not able to score from Mandic. She saw a promotional poster at school that attracted her attention. It wasn't that long ago. And now she's staring down the barrel of becoming an Olympic champion. There'll be posters about her if she can do that. Certainly already the poster girl of Taekwondo in Serbia. And she'll take a one-all scoreline along with Anne-Caroline Graffe to the chair at the end of the first round. Serbian coach asking for plenty. Deep in thought is Graffe, listening to Pavarel. They will be at worst equal in terms of silver medals won at the end of this contest. At best, Graffe has it over her coach with a gold. Yeah, the scoring motions in the first period. You can see Mandic there looking to her coach as she attempts to build on her 1 point score sheet. That was the clenched fist to the body from Graffe. Usually got a point in there. Any more work to be done from these two. The number one seed here, and Caroline Graffe, interestingly enough, she wasn't even the French number one. She wasn't selected initially to represent France in the women's heavyweight. The French number one got injured, and they turned to the second stringer, who now trails by 1 point. Milica Mandic. And interesting too that the World Taekwondo Federation inserted Graffe as the number one seed over the defending gold medalist Espinosa of Mexico, who is not here but did win a bronze. She was defeated by Mandic in the quarterfinal. So Mandic's form obviously good coming into this gold medal game. She gives up a point there with contact to the body from Graffe, so it's 2-2. Referee gets involved. Just redress the protective arm guard, and we're back into it. Almost halfway through this bout. The high contact, did it score? Yes, it did. Mandic with the 3 points for the head contact and has that 3-point lead. The double kick, consecutive kicks in midair, working there. And now halfway through, it's a 3-point margin. Graffe, the favourite, has the work ahead of her. Contact doesn't connect on the score sheet. Has to be power and sustained impact to the trunk to score. She's a world champion. Korea last year became a world champ, Graffe. Also the European champion here in Great Britain this year. Her form is certainly on her side going in. She trails now though, 3 points to 5 in the shadows of the end of the second of the 3 2-minute periods that make up this gold medal bout. The women's heavyweight on the Taekwondo mat. A late attempt at the head of Mandic by Graffe, and she did get one in there late. 2 points added with a turning kick to the trunk just on the death. How important will that be? 5-4 the lead for Mandic from Serbia with just 2 minutes remaining now. Third in the World Championships in Korea in the middleweight division for Mandic, so she's up a weight here at the heavyweight. But she's certainly holding her own, and more importantly, holding a 1-point lead as we look to the highlights there. Support from Serbia. As this 20-year-old looks to become an Olympic champion. High contact. That was what moved the main score in that round from Mandic. Will she need another one of those, or can she defend a 1-point margin over the final 2 minutes? Gold medal here for the taking in the final round of the women's heavyweight. Left and right leg, front and back going at it again, attempting to score to the trunk by the fist. Is the Frenchwoman. Nothing doing there for Graffe. And it's 6-4 as Mandic was given the point with a contact to the body. She gets one now, Graffe. She gets two at 6-all. It was a swinging motion to the body. Awarded 2 points. Nothing in this. Again to the trunk with the fist. Graffe not scoring. She continues to work that maneuver. Be careful in doing that, not to open the body up. 6 points all. If the scores stay tied, there will be a sudden point, 1 minute fourth round. We might not get that far. These two going at it hard. A gold medal there for the taking. Serbia and France. Serbia in front. The immediate reply from France. Mandic and Graffe literally toe to toe. Again working the body. This is Olympic competition at its best. 7 points all. Jabbing with the front leg, Mandic. And again. And now the Serbian gets the point late. Contact to the body. She leads by one. Graffe must respond. And there's a video appeal now. It's coming from the French coach. Averell, the silver medalist in Athens for France. Okay, I'm not sure that won't get lost in translation. 2 points added there in succession to Mandic, and I think, let's listen.
Ask 1 point, of course, two jets, press the button for the punch.
Okay, I think saying there was 1 point there, but not two. Both athletes have scored 3 points in this final round. That's why the 1 point margin stays the same. We haven't seen that before. That was dismissed before it even went to the video review. And the Frenchwoman has lost the chance to appeal again. So, more importantly, Serbia lead by one, 8 points to seven. Mandic over Graffe. The Frenchwoman must score quickly or the goal goes to Serbia. The Serbian scores again. She now leads by two. She's appealing. It doesn't matter. She doesn't need to score again. She is home. That is it. Milica Mandic from Serbia at just 20 years of age. A golden moment in London. Tremendous scenes of jubilation. It's official. Mandic is the Olympic champion. She defeated the champion from Beijing, the reigning gold medalist in the quarterfinals. A dominant display from the Serbian. And for Anne-Caroline Graffe, silver. Oh, so close. 9 points to seven.